Now, the another subdivision will be the external features of parotid gland and relations. Very important, external features and relations. Before we embark on this journey, parotid duct. Now, parotid duct, if we want to draw the parotid duct, again 2 points, surface marking, very important. First point, the first point will be just where external acoustic meatus is there. But in order to draw this point, we need to understand the basic concept of the external ear, auricle. Now, this external auricle will have various anatomical subdivisions, anatomical parts, but we are concerned with only one part, tragus. Of course, the ear component, external ear, middle ear, internal ear will be taken later on in the head and neck region, but here, because of surface marking, first point for parotid duct, tragus. Now, tragus is exactly present just anteroinferior to external acoustic meatus. The tragus is the component part of the external ear above the lobule, tragus. So, point below the tragus will be the first point for surface marking of parotid duct. So, here I mark this point over here. This is the first point for the surface marking of parotid duct. Second point will be, this is the L of the nose, external layers, and this is the upper lip. In between, there should be a midpoint. This is the midpoint here. Second point, midpoint between upper lip and the L of the nose. A line drawn from first point to the second point. If you draw this line, connect it. Middle one third of this line will represent the parotid duct. So therefore, the parotid duct will be the middle one third, and this will serve as the parotid duct. This is the parotid duct. And remember this parotid duct? It is passing through the middle of the anterior border of parotid gland. This is the surface marking of parotid duct. So parotid duct will connect the anterior border. Parotid duct will start from the anterior border of parotid gland, and the passage of parotid duct will be present here, connecting it. The direction will be anteriorly downwards, then it will pierce medially. It will pierce three structures: buccal pad of fat, buccopharyngeal fascia, and buccinator muscle. Buccopharyngeal fascia is a part of fascia which will cover buccinator muscle. Remember, in the face, when you have dissected, remove the entire skin of the face, it is loaded with all the facial musculature. Now these facial muscles, they are a part of superficial fascia, as there is no deep fascia in the face. Deep fascia is completely absent from the face. Only superficial fascia, which contains all the facial muscles and the facial vessels. So these facial muscles, they are present in the superficial fascia. There is no deep fascia in the face, but the deep fascia in the face is represented only at two regions. What are those two regions? Number one, parotid capsule, which is present over the parotid gland, which we have discussed in the previous segment. And the second is buccopharyngeal fascia, which is present on buccinator muscle. So therefore, this parotid duct will pierce, once again it will pierce three structures. It will pass deep inside, medially, pierce three structures. Buccal pad of fat, number one. Number two, buccopharyngeal fascia. And number three, buccinator muscle. After piercing these three structures, remember this is a viva question or MCQ or one mark question answer. Please note it down. After piercing these three structures, it will open into the vestibule of the mouth, opposite the crown of upper second molar tooth. Opposite the crown of upper second molar tooth. It will pierce in the vestibule of the mouth and open into the crown of upper second molar tooth. This is parotid gland. So, remember, out of this parotid duct, so many questions can be asked as one mark. Now, we have completed the outline of parotid gland, parotid duct. Now, remember, in external features and relations, the parotid gland consists of anterior border, posterior border, and medial border, three borders. There will be three borders of the entire parotid gland. One is anterior border, one is posterior border, and one is medial border. What about the surfaces? Surfaces will be, one is superficial surface, other is superior surface, first superficial surface, second superior surface, third will be anterior medial surface, and fourth will be posterior medial surface. Now I am going to draw here on this segment, I am going to draw here one diagram where I will show these surfaces. So therefore, this is the cross section of parotid gland. Remember, it is a transverse section of entire parotid gland. Now I would like to show to you that this will serve, see here, this will serve as anteromedial surface. Here, this will serve as posteromedial surface. Similarly, it will continue. This is the same posteromedial surface. Therefore, this border will separate anteromedial and posteromedial surface. This border will be known as the medial border. It will be known as the medial border. So here, I will mark this as the medial border. Then I will mark this component here. I have to mark this component as posteromedial surface. This will be the posteromedial surface. This side over here, I will mark this much as anteromedial surface. Anteromedial surface. Remember, this is a transverse section. And therefore, now, this will be more laterally, this will be more on the medial side, once again medial side, this will be the lateral side, so obviously this surface will be known as, this entire surface will be known as superficial surface, or it is called lateral surface, so it is called superficial surface. Please mark it, draw it along with me as superficial surface or lateral surface. So therefore, three surfaces are visible in this diagram because it is a sectional, cross-sectional view. Superficial surface, anteromedial surface, posteromedial surface with anterior, with medial border. Now, the fourth surface was visible in this diagram, that is the superior surface. Superior surface. It is concave, superior surface. It is always lying below head of the mandible and external acoustic meatus. Remember this. So therefore, medial border will separate which two surfaces? See the diagram. Medial border will separate anteromedial surface and posteromedial surface. Anterior border will separate which two surfaces? Anterior border will separate anteromedial surface and superficial surface. Posterior border will separate which two surfaces? Posterior border will separate superficial surface and posteromedial surface. Three borders separating two surfaces. Once again, I'll repeat, medial border will separate anteromedial and posteromedial surface. Anterior border will separate anteromedial surface from superficial surface. And posterior border will separate superficial surface from posteromedial surface. Remember that.